Blacks, you know, they're the biggest brand in world rugby. They're the team that everyone wants to beat. They're generally either number one or next to number one in the world. So, you know, they, for a long period of time, have set the standards of the best of what rugby is.
The All Blacks, yeah, it's pretty tough to summarise. I guess they're one of the best rugby teams in the world. Well, they are. They've been setting the benchmark for ever since I can remember. So it's always one of those games when Australia plays New Zealand that you just want to get on top of them, and it's, I guess, it's a pinnacle of rugby.
Fast, furious, and just relentless, I think, in terms of how they go about winning games. There's just an intensity of the way they start games, which is unlike any other team. And it's almost like they're throwing the challenge to you after they've obviously done the haka, to this is how we're going to play. Can you join us? If not, we'll just blow you off the park. And they're great matches to play for that very reason.
Well, the All Blacks are, you know, they're the greatest side in the world at the moment, aren't they? But what people probably don't realise is that, you know, many, many years ago, the South Africans were the benchmark. That's prior to the early 70s when they were basically kicked out of international rugby. They were the benchmark, but now it's certainly the All Blacks. And they're just, you know, the best team in the world. And you can just see over the last number of years that they've quite rarely been the best side.
The Trans-Tasman rivalry is so fierce because we've been going at it so long. They're always the team that we want to beat the most because they're our closest neighbour, and they are currently the number one team in the world, and I guess they've probably been sitting there for the longest amount of time. So we're at number two at the moment, and we're always sort of trying to beat those guys, and if we can get on top of them, we know that I guess we are the best team in the world.
Yeah, both very, very proud sides. And, you know, the New Zealands, I guess, one-on-one are well in front as far as wins are concerned, but they've always been tremendous contests. And, you know, you just give it your absolute all when you play the All Blacks, and that's what you like to do. You like to play the best.
Yeah, the history, like, everyone knows about the Bledisloe Cup just because of the size of it. It's probably the biggest cup, one of the biggest cups in sport, I'd imagine, on a global scale. And it's one which, you know, Australia and New Zealand have a really rich rivalry, and it's definitely developed over the past number of decades because the contests have got closer and closer. But New Zealand have held it for the last 10 years, which we're fully aware of, and the Australian team would love, and the Wallaby team and the Australian public would love to have it back on our shores. And I'm sure those Wallaby players would love that experience of, you know, celebrating after a test match and filling that cup and passing that around. It's one of those special moments, and it means a lot to both countries. I've heard comments along the lines of, you know, we might get the Tri Nations this year, but if we hang on to that Bledisloe Cup, that's the main one we want to hang on to. So it means a lot to both countries.
When we got it back in 98, that was so important for us because we were a team that were improving all the time, but for us that was just this stamp of recognition that what we were doing was right. And it was particularly, it was much more than just winning it back. It was the way we won it back. And winning three games out of three that year was, you know, really something very, very significant in the history of Australian rugby. It's only been achieved once before. And to actually win it on New Zealand soil in Christchurch, and then come back to Australia some weeks later and beat them in the third test as well to affirm that series victory was really important. And then to hold it for the next 4 years after that.